Hey, 42 here. Humankind loves to look up towards new challenges and greater aspirations. Whether we're building immense skyscrapers, climbing the tallest mountains, or reaching for the stars, we never stop striving to better ourselves. But our world has plenty more to explore and discover, even if it means reaching a little lower, perhaps a lot lower, deep beneath the sea and buried far underground, and even at the very center of the Earth. Let's take a look at 7 of the deepest places in the world. Far beneath the chill waters of the Western Pacific Ocean, the Marianas Trench stretches across the seafloor in a realm that light has never touched. The deepest point, appropriately called Challenger Deep, has been measured at 10,994 kilometers below sea level, give or take 40 meters. The bottom of the trench was seen for the very first time on January the 23rd, 1960, by oceanographer Jacques Picard, along with US Navy Lieutenant Don Walsh from within a cramped bathyscaphe. They missed the Challenger Deep by a few meters, but they were still able to observe the floor of the Marianas Trench, which was noted to be, quote-unquote, light and clear, a waste of snuff-coloured ooze. Despite the crushing weight of the water above, the intrepid explorers were certainly shocked to find life waiting for them at the very bottom, in the form of some type of flatfish resembling a sole about 1 foot and 6 inches across. If 16,000 pounds of pressure per square inch can't dissuade life from finding a way, perhaps there's a lesson to be learnt there. Later expeditions revealed other extreme forms of life, like giant amoebas measuring 10 centimeters in diameter. Now, before the nightmare set in, it might be worth noting that the amoebas didn't exactly resemble a single-celled organisms as we think of them, but more like a sea sponge or a coral. Scientists dubbed these creatures xenophyophores, which is science speak for they look like aliens. The era of discovery continues even to this day. Hollywood director and science buff James Cameron performed the deepest solo subdive into the Marianas Trench on March 25, 2012. Using his custom-built submersible, he collected samples of the oozy sediment and even captured 3D video of the entire dive, hoping to gain a better understanding of the ocean's depths and spur support for future expeditions. There's certainly a lot left for us to discover down there. As long as we don't anger Cthulhu, we should be okay. Just a short distance southwest of Johannesburg in South Africa lies perhaps the greatest achievement in the world of mining since the invention of the simple pickaxe. Miners in the Mp9 Gold Mine have been hard at work since 1981, sifting the earth to produce gold from a vein that averages less than a meter wide. An interesting dichotomy when you consider that the Mp9 Gold Mine is the deepest mine in the world, and it's all thanks to that relatively tiny golden thread. Most of the work is done between 2.4 and 3.9 kilometers deep, the latter number being the current world record for mining depth. And the digging continues, extracting 5,400 metric tons of rock daily. Expansion efforts seek to ensure the mine's long-term viability, purely a precautionary measure, as in 2012 alone, the mine produced around 11,500 kilograms of gold. That's $460 million of the golden good stuff. If you're still undecided on a career path, perhaps you might want to consider becoming a miner. But it's not all fun and games that far down into the Earth's crust. The closer you get to the core of our planet, the hotter things get in turn. This is an effect known as the geothermal gradient, and it's a constant concern for the intrepid miners of the Mp9 Gold Mine. If you were to descend to the deepest point in the mine, the temperature of the surrounding strata would reach temperatures of up to 60 degrees Celsius. Consider the harsh, unyielding stone surrounding you, and you've got the makings of an oven. Inhospitable working conditions, for sure. But thanks to a constant stream of slurry ice pumped through the mine, the temperature is maintained at a far more bearable 30 degrees Celsius. Still, a sweltering day in the mines. But hey, at least you won't end up broiled. Caves have long held a special sort of allure for explorers, natural fissures in the terrain which offer nooks and crannies for those brave enough to test their shadowy depths. Krabera Cave, located in a particularly porous area of Western Russia, known as the Arabica Massive, isn't just any old cave. It bears the unique distinction of being the deepest cave in the world. It is with no small measure of respect that some cavers have taken to calling it the Everest of caves, evoking images of the danger and excitement that many find in summiting the tallest mountains. Krabera Cave was recognised for its record depth in August of 2004, after a particularly stoic band of cave explorers followed its twisting path downward to a total depth of 2,080 metres. It's the only natural formation known to humankind greater than 2 kilometres deep, and it even has a reserve of water at the very bottom, known as the Terminal Slump. That's as far as a team of cavers could go with the equipment that they had with them. In 2007, and again in 2012, a Ukrainian diver by the name of Gennady Samokin climbed down to the sump with all the necessary equipment to plunge into the icy water and map the tail end of the cave. He earned world records with both dives, and added another 98 meters to the total depth in the process. So if you've ever fancied a long climb with a brief swim at the bottom, then there's a bloody scary idea for you to add to your next vacation. Once you're through spelunking in Krabera Cave, head east into Siberia to find the next stop on our whirlwind tour of the world's deepest places, Lake Baikal. The depth isn't the only interesting thing about this crescent-shaped reservoir cutting through the Russian mainland. Though it is both the deepest freshwater lake and the deepest continental body of water to be found on our planet. Besides reaching incredible depths, there's plenty of other facts about the lake to get excited about, especially if you're a scientist. Geologically, Lake Baikal is the oldest freshwater lake in the world, and it contains nearly 20% of the world's unfrozen freshwater reserve. Not to say that it doesn't freeze over from time to time, it is Siberia after all. The lake and its surrounds are also home to an incredibly diverse collection of flora and fauna, with some estimates identifying around 1,340 different species of animals living harmoniously with upwards of 570 species of plants. A lush, thriving ecosystem to be catalogued in and around an ancient lake of remarkable depths. And those eager scientists might even be able to make it home for dinner. We're going to have to bend the rules a bit for this next one. Though the Bentley Subglacial Trench in Western Antarctica isn't technically covered in water, it is, well, covered in water, but not the wet kind. The trench is actually the lowest point on the Earth not covered by an ocean or other form of flowing water. Sitting at 2.5 kilometers below sea level, as you might expect, subglacial means that it is sequestered beneath the frozen mass of majestic glacier, surrounded by many other similar stretches of ice all across the Antarctic continent. This means that the Bentley Subglacial Trench is actually subterranean, though it's still a point on the Earth's surface, just not one you could walk to. I told you we'd have to cheat a bit. It was named by the Advisory Committee on Antarctic Names in 1961, in honour of Charles R. Bentley and his contributions to Antarctic research as the Chief Traverse Seismologist at Bride Station, between 1957 and 1959. Seeing as he was the one who led the expedition which first located the trench and recorded its depth, it seems an appropriate legacy for him to leave behind in the snowy wastes. Who knows, there could be a secluded spot in Antarctica just waiting for you to slap your name all over it as well. When in doubt, start drilling straight down, and don't stop until the Earth itself rejects you. Not exactly sensible advice, but someone involved with the Kola SuperDeep Borehole project must have heard it somewhere and really took it to heart. During the Cold War, there was a constant back and forth between the United States and the Soviet Union, each seeking to one-up each other on the global stage. Scientific endeavours flew fast and furious, one of the results being the Soviets' decision to set a drill into the ground of the Kola Peninsula and dig as deep as possible. There were certainly valid scientific reasons for the project, but it almost sounds as if they were just waiting for an excuse to do it. The drilling began in 1970 and it didn't stop until 1994, producing what we call today the Kola Superdeep Borehole, the deepest hole ever drilled to date, and the deepest artificial point in the world, reaching a mind-boggling 12 kilometers into the crust of our planet. That's deeper than even the Challenger Deep. In the end, the borehole encountered the same issue as the miners in the Mp9 Gold Mine. Things get really hot that deep underground. Temperatures at the end of the shaft climb to around 180 degrees Celsius. No, not Fahrenheit, but Celsius. That's a brain-melting 356 Fahrenheit. The equipment simply couldn't continue to function in those conditions, and so the Kola SuperDeep borehole had reached its end. But rumours continue to swirl around about what exactly brought about the conclusion of the drilling. There are campfire ghost stories about microphones that were lowered into the shaft, which recorded the sounds of tortured screams. What's really going on at the centre of the Earth? Well, let me tell you. At the very centre of our planet lies a sphere of solid iron. At least as best as we can tell with current data. Deeper than the molten mantle and liquid metal outer core, the inner core seems to be formed of a massive, non-uniform ball of iron. It is this core, and the extreme heat as a result of several factors working in tandem, that serves to heat the planet from within. The same heat which wards off any attempt to burrow through the crust. It's as if the underworld is feverishly trying to keep us at bay. There must be something going on down there. The estimated temperature at the boundary between the molten metal of the outer core and the solid inner core is around 5,600 degrees Kelvin. To put that into some perspective, the temperature of our sun's surface is 5,800 degrees Kelvin, only 200 more. Some predict that the Earth's core might even be hotter than the surface of the sun. Thanks to pressure, friction, and radioactive elements, the Earth essentially has a miniature sun burning at its very heart. Perhaps we will never get to see the very core of the Earth with our own eyes. But we can dream, and every crevice, borehole, and trench that we discover can bring us that much closer to understanding the unsearchable depths beneath us. And no matter how deep we go, it can only get warmer and brighter once the darkest places are behind us. Thanks for the view, subscribe for more 42.